Hello, we will be looking at Alpine Quest version 2.2.1b. I'm going to be talking about how to set a target, explorer mode, following a path, and proximity alerts. Be sure to check out some of my other videos on Alpine Quest that cover setup, storing maps, and other functions. One of the fastest ways to set a target, if you know the location on the map, is to move the center of the screen to the location on the map of the target. Now, on the center of the screen, touch the black circle. This brings up a menu. It has options of set target and create a place mark. The place mark option would be useful if you wanted to use this location multiple times. The Tools menu lets you copy and paste the location coordinates. We're going to choose to set as target. Now as we move around the map, we see the target point is a red dot, and there is a red line extending from the center of the screen to this point. There's also red numbers saying the distance in feet. Next, we'll turn on the GPS of our device. On the bottom left hand, there's a set of crosshairs to open up the GPS menu, location menu. We'll toggle on the GPS position. Close the menu, and we see our position is shown as a blue dot. As we move around the screen, there is a blue line from our position to the center of the screen, along with the distance from us to the center. There's the red line from the center of the screen to the destination. We can recenter it by pressing the crosshairs. Now we are centered on our location. It shows the distance to the target that we have set. Now we can clear this target by touching the center of the screen, the circle at the center of the screen. And in this menu, we could set a new target, or we can hit the X choice to clear it. We have now cleared the target, and I will show you how to set a target from a waypoint. On the screen, there is a point listed as South Quad. I'm going to touch that point, and that brings up a menu that shows the name of the point. By touching that, we have a submenu that lets us set it as a target, or jump to that as the center of the map, or set up a proximity alert for that target. Now I'm going to select set as target. Now I'm going to clear that target by touching the center of the screen, the circle there, and select the X to cancel the targeting. Next, if you have a waypoint next to another waypoint or next to a GPS track and you touch it, the menu that comes up will show both of those items. And then from here, you can choose which one you want to target or access. So I've selected the Sage Hall Corner waypoint. And here we have a menu where we can set it as a target, which we will do that again. Once you've set a target, you probably want to enter Explorer mode to help you reach that target. You do this by touching the crosshairs in the menu on the bottom left. In that submenu, the top choice is Explorer mode. Select this mode. In Explorer mode, the map is faced in the direction you are going, and it shows your speed and distance to the target. If you're moving, it also has an estimated time of arrival and an arrow pointing at the target. If you pan on the map to some location, you can return to the map being centered on your location by touching the center circle button. It's at the bottom right next to the X. To exit Explorer mode, we will touch the X at the bottom right corner. to untarget the Sage Hall GPS point, touch the center of the screen, and hit the X in that menu to stop targeting. Now we will look at using Explore mode to track or follow a GPX path. Touch the path you want to follow to bring the name of the track up. Then touch the name to bring the menu options for that path. The first choice is follow path, but you have other options of the profile, exporting it, the details of it, editing the color, or deleting it. Touching follow path brings up an options menu. The follow path menu has a list of options. At the bottom is the choice of opening in explore mode, which is generally what you want to do. You can also follow the path in reverse order or follow it as a loop. At the top are two settings of distance. I usually leave them at the default. One is to warn you if you get more than 82 feet away from the GPS track you're following, but you can change it to other options. And the top is to set a target follow distance. And this is to keep, as you're following the track, the arrow will point ahead this far to a point this far ahead on the track. If it was pointing to the end of the track and you were following a circular track, it would not be pointing ahead of you. And depending on how windy the track is versus how straight and how fast you're traveling, you might need to use a different distance in this setting. To follow the path, we will click OK, and this enters explore mode. Where again, it shows the distance to the target, our speed, and it would display an arrow if we were in motion. If you uncenter the map from yourself as you're scrolling around, it shows a line from our position to the center and to either the endpoint or to a waypoint on the GPS course that we're following. At the bottom right, there is the return to center button, and we'll return to center. And then we will hit X to exit the explore mode at the bottom right. To stop following and exit follow mode, touch the center of the screen, and from this menu where you can set a target, you select the X to unselect the target or unselect following. If this video has been useful, be sure to like and subscribe. If you have any questions, please comment below.